In this video, we're talking about the cranking system and how to perform a voltage drop test on the whole system. So why volt drop testing? What are we going to do? So with my cranking system, my starter motor is just a 12 volt component, but it demands an incredibly high amount of amperage. It is the single highest amperage consuming device throughout the vehicle. So we know it's going to use a lot of amperage, and so that means that small amounts of resistance, say from corrosion going into a battery cable or a bad ground strap going from my engine block to my chassis, any of these things that have resistance where we don't intend for there to be resistance can create voltage drop. And that drop at high current loads, you know, 200, 300, 400 amps, result in quite a bit of voltage. When we see that happen, that can be high enough to the point where the starter motor won't run or it will run more slowly. And so volt drop testing is one way that I can isolate and find those faults using my voltmeter. So we're going to use my voltmeter to set up and do a handful of common measurements to see, you know, where would we look for these problems. To do that, first I need to make sure that the vehicle will only crank. So I'm going to go ahead and disconnect power from my fuel pump and then we'll start testing. So for my first test, I'm going to go ahead and set up for DC volts. Get my dial there, make sure that I'm on the proper configuration for my ports. I'm going to go ahead and range the meter so that we don't get any shifts of the range while we're conducting the test. And we're going to start by just looking at what is essentially my source voltage. So I'm going to go just with my positive and negative on my battery. We'll go ahead and crank it. So that's test one, is really just deciding that my battery has the ability to supply enough voltage. We saw it dip to somewhere in the mid 11s, 10 for a second whenever we cranked it. So we're going to move on and go ahead and do our next test. So that first test with positive and negative helps me understand what's the total voltage available to the system. And so as I go through all of these tests, if I wanted to, I can add them all up and verify that I've captured the voltage traveling through the whole circuit, right? So if the total available at my battery was say 11.3, as I go through all these individual wires, connections, and components, the path from positive all the way through ground back to the battery should total, right? The sum of those tests should total what I saw just now as the source. So for our next test, I want to audit the cable that goes to my starter. So I've got a connection here for my battery positive or B plus. That cable is really two cables. One goes into my fuse box up here. The other one splits off. This one trails down and ends up at my starter. I'm going to make one connection here at battery positive, and I'm going to make the other one down here at what we'll call our B plus connection. So I'm going to pull back that little boot, make a connection right there. This one should show up as zero initially, and when I crank, I should see a voltage. To make this a little bit easier to read as I go and I use the ignition to crank the car, I'm going to hit record, and we'll record our max. So here it shows my max drop was 0.42 volts. This is just under the specification. We want to see this be half a volt or less. So this means that there's enough resistance in the cable going from the battery to the starter to consume almost half a volt. If we drop that half a volt in the cable, that means I've got half a volt less to be consumed at the starter. If I had greater than a half volt drop on this cable, that means that it may have excessive resistance and need to be replaced. For our next test, we want to verify that the solenoid on the starter is not consuming any voltage. So our voltage comes in on this cable right here that goes to the battery. The solenoid in here has coils holding and pulling in order to move a plunger and close a set of contacts. That contact then sends the current from this B plus post down here to this motor or M post. So we're going to put one lead on B plus, one lead on M, and crank it and see what we get. So here when we first hook this one up, that solenoid is an open circuit currently, so we will see our source voltage. If I want to record this like I did before, I'm going to set it to the minimum so I see what it drops to. So we only saw 0.05 volts, which is a great reading. This one should be under half a volt. If I saw more than half a volt drop on this solenoid, I'd want to replace it or the whole starter assembly. So the next measurement we're going to make is from the M terminal or motor terminal and input right here to battery ground. So this measurement helps me understand exactly how many volts are making their way to the starter. We are leaving at one step, and that's our next test. Next, we need to look at how many volts are being dropped on the ground side. To measure my ground path, I'm going to take my lead here and just put it on the case of the starter. Find a good spot, give it a little scratch to make sure I've got a good connection, and we'll leave the other one on the negative post of the battery. We'll go ahead and reset our meter and crank the vehicle. So there, before my lead fell off, we saw 0.22 volts go through that. And so that's helping me understand the condition of the ground straps that exist between the engine block and transaxle, where the starter is grounded, and the chassis, which is where this cable is grounded. So the last thing that I'm going to check is the S terminal. That's the control terminal. So this is 12 volts with a lower amperage that interacts with my ignition switch, my range, you know, transmission range, or neutral safety switch. And I want to make sure that I've got a full 12 volts coming here. So I'm going to check that by putting one lead on my positive connection at my battery, the other lead on my S terminal, and then I've got to crank the car again. Initially, this is going to show as 12 volts because we're gaining a ground connection through the solenoid windings right now. And so we're going to look at the minimum on this one. So here we've got 0.55 volts on my control circuit. Control circuit thresholds can be as much as 1 volt. It takes less work to do that solenoid, and we know that the control circuit's going to have much more in terms of connections. It's going through the ignition switch, neutral safety, the range switch, and some connectors before it makes it down here.